Simple question. Which of these items is the healthiest? Is it this salad, this bracelet, this eye mask, or this badge necklace thing? Well, thanks to science, I can now use my healthometer to see which of these releases the most healthy particles. First, the salad. Nothing really here. That's odd. And the bracelet? Okay, getting a little better, starting to detect some health particles now. How about the eye mask? Now we're cooking with gas. And finally, the badge thing. Ladies and gentlemen, we have a winner. Wait, this isn't my healthometer. Somebody seems to have switched it for a Geiger counter. That's right, folks. These so-called wellness products, which all purport to do everything from boost your mood to cure your diseases and boost your health, are actually fairly radioactive. All of these items are sold as negative ion products, which are claimed to produce negative ions and be good for you. This isn't even the first time we've talked about these either. Last year, I made a video deep diving into these quack medicine nonsense products and did a series of tests to not only show that they're radioactive, but determine exactly what radioactive element was inside of them. Last time, we talked about these bracelets and pendants and several other items, and I want to quickly review those findings before we talk about some amazing updates and these new products that I found recently. So, to review, last time we did four tests. First, we measured the items with a Geiger counter to get an idea of how radioactive they are. Then, we used a device called a cloud chamber to actually see the radioactive particles coming off of them. These tests alone were pretty damning, but I wanted to know exactly what was in them. To do that, I used gamma spectroscopy and measured the spectrum of gamma rays coming off the items. As a quick refresher, gamma rays are just very high-energy rays of light that come from the decay of radioactive elements. Each element will release gamma rays at specific wavelengths, so by measuring the spectrum, it's very easy to tell what's in the sample. In this case, it turned out to be thorium, a radioactive element next to uranium on the periodic table. Just to double-check this result and confirm it, I sent a bracelet to the fantastic Adam McCombs, who runs an electron microscope lab, and he was able to use the microscope to also measure what material was in here, and his results matched mine. Some of the products we looked at last time were truly horrific. The bracelets are made by just mixing thorium dioxide powder into the plastic as it's made, and end up shedding radioactive dust into your environment as you're wearing it. And considering you're meant to wear it all the time, this could well mean breathing in some of that dust. Worse still was this massager wand, which literally just had a pile of thorium dioxide powder inside, which could be accessed by pulling on the back plug. And the degeneracy didn't stop there. Some of the worst of these were full pieces of clothing or bedsheets, all potentially laced with this material. If you'd like to see a more in-depth analysis, I've linked to the previous video below and in the cards of this video. All of these items use the label negative ion and purport to release so-called negative ions, which they claim are good for you, when in reality, these products either do nothing or just slowly give you cancer, potentially. Now, this isn't to be confused with these air ionizers, which use electricity to generate those negative ions. But like the bracelets, they're quack nonsense all the same. Sure, they put out negative ions, and at least they're not radioactive, but they also release ozone, which is poison. So, as a rule, when it comes to products that claim to make you instantly more healthy, you're better off just eating a salad and avoiding all this horseshit entirely. Now, before I talk about the new and equally horrific items that I found, I want to give a very exciting update. Since the last video, I was actually contacted by both representatives of Amazon and the US Nuclear Regulatory Commission about the video, and was asked to file a formal complaint with both. As a result, Amazon has now pulled dozens and dozens of these dangerous quack products from their site. And better still, the NRC has banned the sale of these items in the US, and at least two companies that were making them have been shut down. To say that this is a massive win is an understatement. I honestly never thought that a stupid YouTube video could make such a real impact, but I am thrilled that it did. Now it is so much harder for these quacks to sell their products, and people are much safer for it. But that's not to say the fight is over. The snake oil salesmen that make these products have simply found new ways of marketing their garbage. Instead of negative ion, now they call the products things like quantum energy, or scalar energy, or similar vague nonsense terms. But nonetheless, they are much harder to find. So, now let's talk about the new items I found, and then I want to talk about what to do about them. Now that I know how seriously the NRC takes these issues, it's so much easier to find and report them when they pop up. Now, what exactly did I find? Well, you saw them in the intro. The first are these eye masks from a company called Energy Armor. With the bracelets, I saw some people argue that the risk from the dust was minimal, but come on, strapping these things to your face and gently huffing the dust all night or getting it in your eyes, that can't possibly be good. I ran the exact same test as last time, first checking with a Geiger counter and then using my gamma spectrometer to determine the element. To my utter lack of surprise, they too were full of thorium. However, what was interesting was I picked up a bracelet from the same company and it was totally empty, not even a trace of radiation. Which is awesome, because now instead of actively polluting its customers' environment with radioactive dust, they've instead just committed fraud by claiming a bracelet releases ions when they definitely don't and is just a piece of silicon. Moving on from the eye mask, there's another company called Numi that makes the Numi card. It's this conference badge looking thing that even came with a lanyard, but wow, is this thing radioactive. I have a fair collection of radioactive samples, and this thing is one of the hotter items in my collection. The only thing spicier than this is a piece of uranium-glazed pottery called Fiestaware, which maxes out at about 12 microsieverts per hour. The Numi card hits a toasty 5.3 microsieverts per hour, which is about 5 times as radioactive as even the hottest bracelet. Though the eye mask was still a nice toasty 2.4. What I found really terrifying was that when you go to the Numi card website, one of their other products is the Numi patch. This to me implies that it's something you stick onto yourself and God knows what's in it and what it's leaching into the user's body. Now, I need to make something very clear. Handling something like this for short periods of time is actually absolutely safe. Even a few hours of exposure won't hurt you as long as none of the dust from these items ends up in your lungs. The radiation itself isn't strong enough at these levels to hurt you from short exposures. You're at no higher risk of cancer from handling this for a few minutes than anyone else. However, when the designed purpose of the thing is to be worn 24/7, 365 days a year, you start getting into the danger zone. Especially if that radioactive dust gets inside you, which seems likely when you're literally strapping it to your face. Interestingly, this is actually the same reason why uranium-glazed pottery, like I showed before, is actually remarkably safe, even though it's more radioactive. The uranium is well contained in the glaze, so as long as it doesn't chip or fracture, it's totally safe to handle. My piece was cut before it was sent to me, so I keep it in a plastic bag to contain any dust. But an intact piece of Fiestaware is totally safe to drink out of, for example, as long as it's intact. The reason the negative ion stuff is dangerous is exposure time is much higher than a dinner plate, and the dust is uncontained and sheds easily, or worse still, pure powdered radioactive material is contained in the items and is easy enough to release by accident. Which does make it a bit funny when schools get evacuated from a kid bringing in a piece of Fiestaware. Unless they throw it in a wood chipper and have the rest of their classmates line up in front of the output, it's actually a pretty safe item to show off if you're careful not to smash it. Radiation isn't a boogeyman, you just need to understand the risks and dangers. Generally, keeping to short exposures within dose limits and making sure there's no dust, and you're safe. Which is why I tend to make fun of shows like Chernobyl, which tend to get that very, very wrong. But it's also why the negative ion products should be avoided and ideally just not sold. They violate all of those rules. They're inherently dusty and are meant to be worn for extended periods of time. So, what do we do about this? Well, the great thing is, like I said, the NRC takes all of this very seriously. So when you go onto the NRC website, there's this giant Report a Concern button near the top of the page. This brings you to another page where there's a selection of things that you can do. Personally, what I suggest is emailing their allegations department. Now, obviously, you don't want to spam their inbox, and please don't do that. But writing a simple, professional letter with as much detail about the items in question is the best way to go about it. In my case, I'll be writing to them about the Numi card and Energy Armor, and outlining exactly what I found. I'll include the Geiger counter measurements and the results of the gamma spectroscopy, as well as links to the products themselves. Once you file a complaint, someone from the department will reach out. In my case, when I was contacted after the last video went out, I got on a phone call with the fantastic ladies in the allegation department and explained the situation. I then provided all the information I just explained and was then sent a letter via email with the contents of my claim and what they were going to do about it. Basically, it said that they'd be contacting each of the companies and sellers and would send me another letter in 30 days once they've made their decisions and contacted the companies. Sure enough, 30 days later, another letter arrived detailing the results, which in this case was banning several companies from selling their products in the US. Now, to be clear, not all radioactive items are banned for sale in the consumer market, just ones deemed frivolous by the NRC. So, the radioactive material must serve a purpose, it can't just be haphazard. So, thoriated welding rods are allowed, but thorium-laced underwear, not so much. And yes, those were some of the items we looked at in the last video. By the time this video goes out, I'll have filed a new complaint with them about the new items, as well as a few stragglers I found on Amazon. But if you find products like these, you're absolutely encouraged to write in, not just to the NRC, but whatever your local regulatory commission is in your country. I'm Canadian, so I'll also be writing to the Canadian Nuclear Safety Commission as well, for example. Personally, I need to say a huge thanks to my friend Emil Grafstra, who tipped me off about these products in the first place, and about the new ones, like the NUMI card. Without that tip, people would still be buying these and putting their health at risk, so huge props to him. And before I wrap up, I also need to thank the sponsor of this video, NordVPN. While a radioactive bracelet definitely won't protect you from EM radiation, NordVPN is the perfect service to protect yourself while you're online. For those that don't know, NordVPN is a virtual private network service. Normally, when you're browsing, you connect directly to a website, but when you do this, your ISP, or whoever's Wi-Fi you're using, can see what sites you're browsing. They may not be able to see what you're doing on the sites you visit, but just knowing what sites people visit can tell you a lot about them. Considering my hobbies include learning about nuclear and particle physics, it's one way to prevent myself from ending up on even more lists. The way it works is that NordVPN acts like a middleman, so instead of directly connecting to your next site on your internet rabbit hole, you first connect to Nord's super-fast servers, and that's all your ISP or other people watching can see. From there, your traffic is forwarded to your site of choice, and you have much more privacy. The other great part of that is that it also unblocks sites which may not be available to you. Here in Canada, I often get this annoying message that says certain videos or sites aren't available in my country. Using Nord's more than 5,500 servers in 60 countries, you can make your traffic look like it's coming from the right country and get around that without issue. Nord currently has a special deal, and their 2-year plan is being offered at a huge discount, and even comes with a bonus 1 month free when you use coupon code ThoughtEmporium, or visit nordvpn.com/ThoughtEmporium. So protect yourself online today by clicking the link in the description, or going to nordvpn.com/ThoughtEmporium to get in on this great deal. And finally, I need to say a huge thank you to my amazing patrons, channel members, and supporters on Ko-fi that make these videos possible. For those interested, patrons and members also get access to my supporter Discord, so if that's something that interests you, or you just want to help keep the flow of science videos coming, there's some links below. I've also put links to the previous video, as well as the NRC's site below, if you want to see some of the other crazy products we looked at last time, or if you happen to find any more of these while you're shopping online. And of course, if you enjoyed this video, be sure to subscribe and ring that bell to see when I post new videos. That's all for now, and I'll see you next time.